An interesting feature about the cardiac action potential is a plateau. But why exactly is it seen? We will find out the reason as we study the action potential in cardiac muscle in this video. Welcome back to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Before starting, I recommend watching a separate video on the generation of action potential first. Although we will be covering all the basics in this video also, your understanding will be better if you have watched that video. Now let's get started. This is a ventricular muscle cell. The ionic composition around here is similar to all other cells in the body. The sodium concentration is higher outside the cell, so it tends to diffuse in. Potassium concentration is high inside the cell, so it tends to diffuse out. Finally, calcium concentration is also higher outside, so it tends to diffuse in. Now this graph is showing membrane potential versus time. Resting membrane potential in ventricular muscle is about minus 90 millivolt. We know that at the heart, impulses are generated at the SA node. As the impulse reaches this point, the action potential will appear here. It begins with voltage-gated fast sodium channels. The incoming impulse opens this channel. This opening allows the rapid influx of a large number of sodium ions. As sodium is a positively charged ion, it makes inside of the cell electropositive, and the potential reaches about 15 millivolt very rapidly. This phase is called phase 0, upstroke, or initial depolarization. Next, the fast sodium channels close. This prevents the rapid influx of sodium. Also, a small quantity of potassium leaks out through potassium channels. This leads to a little bit of repolarization. This is called phase 1 or initial repolarization. Now comes the interesting part. 1. Soon after the onset of the action potential, fast potassium channels close. So the efflux of potassium ions stops. And 2. Cardiac muscles have L type of calcium channels. L means long lasting, but I like to call them lazy channels. Yes, they are lazy because they are slow to open and slow to close. They are activated during the upstroke and opens slowly. Now they allow the influx of calcium into the myocyte. Because of their slow nature, they stay open for a longer time and close very slowly. This allows an influx of calcium for quite some time. Thus, two things are going on at present. Potassium is not moving out, and at the same time, calcium is continuously moving in. This loading of positive ions keeps the membrane depolarized for some time and thus creates a plateau in the action potential. Due to this long plateau, the contraction time is also longer in cardiac muscle. So that was phase 2 or plateau. Eventually though, the calcium channels do close, so the influx of calcium stops. And slow potassium channels open, so the efflux of potassium starts. Due to the exit of the net positive charge, the membrane returns to the resting negative potential. This repolarization phase is called phase 3 or final repolarization. Then of course we have resting membrane potential till the next action potential. This is called phase 0. So this was the action potential in ventricular muscle. Now let's talk about how the ionic balance is restored. We have seen that during an action potential, sodium moves in, potassium moves out, and calcium moves in. To restore the balance, we have sodium-potassium ATPase pump, sodium-calcium exchanger, and calcium ATPase pump on the membrane. Sodium-potassium ATPase pump moves sodium out and potassium in using energy from ATP. Sodium-calcium exchanger actively moves calcium out using the downhill entry of sodium into the cell. Don't worry about the sodium entering here. It will be moved out by the sodium-potassium ATPase pump. And finally, we have calcium pumps that move calcium out using energy directly from the ATP. So this was all about the action potential in cardiac muscle. Now let's have a quick summary. Action potential in cardiac muscle has 5 phases. Phase 0 is due to the opening of fast sodium channels and rapid influx of sodium. Phase 1 or initial depolarization is due to closure of the fast sodium channels and efflux of a small quantity of potassium through open potassium channels. Phase 2 or plateau is due to the opening of slow or L-type of calcium channels leading to calcium influx and closure of potassium channels which prevents efflux of potassium. The calcium channels stay open for quite some time, so we get long plateau. Then phase 3 or final repolarization is due to closure of L-type calcium channels that prevent further calcium entry and opening of slow potassium channels leading to potassium efflux. Phase 4 is resting membrane potential till the next action potential. To restore the ionic balance, sodium-potassium ATPase pump moves sodium out and potassium in, and sodium-calcium exchanger and calcium pump moves the calcium out. We will talk about spread of action potential in cardiac muscle in a separate video. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.